Have you ever wondered how your new flat-screen TV got from a factory in Asia to your local big-box store in the northeastern U.S.? It starts before your purchase, when a U.S. supplier orders TVs from a manufacturer in Asia. TVs, along with countless other products, begin their international journey from an Asian port to the store via the integrated transportation supply chain. And every link in that chain must work in a precisely coordinated sequence with the next. Each step, ocean shipping, unloading at the port, trucking, warehousing, and freight rail, all play a vital role in this tightly integrated network, a marvel of modern logistics. Let's join the journey, most of which is arranged by the ocean carrier, as our container ship is en route to California. Port of call, Long Beach. The largest cargo ships are as long as 4 football fields and can carry more than 10,000 containers, each 40 feet long. This container alone holds 800 flat-screen TVs, one of them yours. After waiting for an open space at the port, the cargo ship docks, and then...
The next link in the chain. Our container is unloaded from the ship, inspected, and cleared by customs. Then it is either loaded directly onto a rail car or onto a truck chassis and transported to a nearby intermodal rail facility serving the port. These short-distance truck movements are called drayage.
At the rail intermodal facility, the container is transferred from the truck chassis to a rail car, which is then built into a train that's heading east to Chicago.
In Chicago, our rail car is handed off to another railroad to take it the rest of the way to its final rail destination.
Once the train arrives at an intermodal facility on the East Coast, our container is lifted off its rail car and positioned for pickup. The railroad notifies the ocean carrier, or receiver, who then
arranges for the driver, dray truck, and chassis to deliver the container to the next facility, where workers coordinate the unloading of the container, warehousing, and final distribution of the contents. And as soon as the retail outlet is ready to accept it, the products, including your TV, are delivered to stores.
And that now empty shipping container? It's once again picked up by dray trucks and returned to the rail intermodal facility or a nearby port terminal, where it will re-enter the transportation supply chain under the control of the cargo ship company that owns it.
On average, when everything goes smoothly, it takes around 45 days for that container to reach the Northeast U.S. from its manufacturer in Asia. But issues like factory shutdowns, port congestion, lack of warehouse capacity, or shortages of chassis, trucks, or drivers can cause significant delays and have a ripple effect across the entire chain.
Your flat-screen TV is just a tiny fraction of the 61 tons of goods per American delivered each year by this transportation network. Freight rail is a resilient and indispensable link in this supply chain, which keeps America's economy moving forward.